Hey guys, I'm Adrian.
Hey, I'm Nick.
And welcome to another episode of Connect. So today we brought our friend Ben Gilboa here, who's going to talk about some of the benefits of sub-gigahertz technology, as well as a specific stack that TI has brought to the table, the TI-15.4 stack.
Yeah, and so to me, from my knowledge of sub-1 gigahertz, it's a little different at the 2.4 gigahertz space. There's some very well-known and well-defined standards that probably you guys have all heard of, like BLE and Thread and Zigbee and stuff of that nature. But that really doesn't exist at the sub-1 gigahertz space. Ben, can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, absolutely. So the sub-1 gigahertz band is a little bit different, like you said, from the 2.4 gigahertz. It has much more frequencies that work a little bit different around the world. So in the US, it's mainly the 915 megahertz. In Europe, it's more of the 868. And in China, 433 megahertz. And the space is very fragmented. Like you said, there is no standard like Wi-Fi or BLE or Zigbee that took over the sub-1 gigahertz space. There are some that are trying for different purposes, like Sigfox or LoRa or NB-IoT that is coming out. But as of now, there is no one standard that took over.
So I would imagine without a standard in the space, it presents maybe a challenge for customers who want to develop in the sub-1 gigahertz space but don't have a legacy in RF development or developing their own protocols, which from my understanding is why TI developed the TI-15.4 stack. Can you tell us at a high level what that stack is and how it applies to the sub-gig space?
Yes. So exactly for the reason that you say, TI decided to develop its own stack that is based on the 15.4, 802.15.4 G standard. It's the same IEEE standard that the Zigbee and the Thread technologies rely on, but this is in the sub-1 gigahertz space. So we developed our own standard that takes this, developed our own network that is based on this IEEE protocol, but it adds much more on top of that. We had more rates. We support 50 kilobit per second, 5 kilobit per second for long range, and 200 kilobit per second. We have solution for commissioning, for addressing, how to join the network, how to leave the network, and much more.
Very cool. And with this, the introduction of the 15.4 stack, you know, what are some of the benefits of sub-gigahertz? Why would a customer or developer even consider a sub-gigahertz stack versus some of the more established 2.4 gigahertz technologies?
Yeah, so there are several good reasons to use the sub-1 gigahertz spectrum. Foremost is the range. Sub-1 gigahertz brings a much longer range than the 2.4 gigahertz. This is just a simple physics. Mm-hmm. Of wave propagation. It also had some simple features like how the signal bends around walls and propagates through walls. So bending around corners. Wow. And propagate through walls. This is another advantage that add to the robustness of the link. Mm-hmm. So you get much better link budget in the sub-1 gigahertz. And in addition to that, it's much lower power. So if you want to have a long range, low power network, sub-1 gigahertz might be actually a very good fit for that.
Gotcha. And what are the types of end equipments or applications that can benefit from, you know, longer range or better battery life?
Yeah, so typical end equipments that use the sub-1 gigahertz are in building automation, like security systems, or HVAC systems. So for example, if you want to have a security system with a bunch of sensor nodes, like a motion detector or a door and window sensors, glass break detector, etc., this is typically used in the sub-1 gigahertz band. Another end equipment that use sub-1 gigahertz is metering in under grid infrastructure. Like electricity meters, flow meters for gas and water. They also use the sub-1 gigahertz band a lot.
Awesome, very cool.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. And so it sounds like to me, if a customer wants to develop at the sub-1 gigahertz band, they can take our device that's supported on the SimpleLink platform, the 15.4 stack, and focus on developing their application rather than building out their whole network protocol. Is that kind of the main idea of the stack?
Yes, absolutely. So building a network requires an expertise. You must be you must understand how networks work. You must design and plan. We provide the network which is flexible. It has two major modes. One is the asynchronous mode, mainly for sleepy nodes who only need to transmit like once in a while. Okay. You sleep all the time. Whenever you want to transmit asynchronously, you just wake up, you transmit your message, and you go back to sleep. You remain part of the network. The other mode is the synchronous mode, when the nodes wake up periodically, totally configurable to listen for a beacon, similar to the concept of the Wi-Fi. This is more important if you are expecting downlink messages, like trigger messages from the cloud or an aggregator down to the node. So we provide those two modes, along with frequency hopping, which is another important feature for sub-1 GHz. And if you just take that network, along with some other goodies that it comes with, like security, over-the-air upgrade capabilities, you can just focus on your application and let the TI expert do the rest.
That's great.
All right. Well, thanks, Ben. Thanks for shedding some light on the 15.4 stack, some applications it can be used in, and some of the advantages of sub-1 GHz. And thank you guys for joining this episode of Connect, where Ben kind of broke down the 15.4 stack for us. If you'd like to interact, suggest topics, ask questions, be sure to tweet at me, @sensortocloud. And if you'd like to learn more about the stack or sub-1 GHz in general, you can go to ti.com/longrange, and you can go to ti.com/simplelink to learn more about the SimpleLink platform. Next week, be sure to tune in. We're going to have a hands-on demo with some very cool SimpleLink technology, so don't miss that. Thanks, guys. Cool.